Welcome to the meditation class. So, as I mentioned before, this is a mixture of meditation and shamanic energy work. So, we'll be opening what we call our Wiracocha, which is our eighth chakra. So, we all know we have our seven chakras in the body. If you do any sort of more work, you realize, or you've seen in the diagrams and images of a halo up here. When we're working with shamanism, it's like a golden globe, and it keeps all our history within the DNA of everything we're doing. So all we're going to do is bring our hands up, and we're going to spread it out around us. We're going to do it over the class as well. And then we'll use the fire stick. When we do a fire ceremony outside, it's a much bigger fire, and the sticks will still be the same, but this is more at home. So anything, any negativity we blow into this, and it can be up to seven different things, and the intensity of how you blow into it would maybe depend on the emotion that's there. So it could be someone cutting you up on the road today, or something financially has happened, or your health, or something that's keeping you awake in the evening. So we can blow that into there, and then we put it to the fire, and we just watch it burn and release all those emotions and energies back to the healing power of light and love and back to the universe. And then from there, we'll start with the meditation and working with the breathing and affirmations and talk from there. So if you just like to sit comfortably, just do a couple of deep breaths. And on the next in-breath, just having your hands in a prayer pose, the prayer position in front of your chest. And then on the next in-breath, bring this up into this eighth chakra, just above your head. It's like a golden globe. Putting your hands inside, and then you spread this out all around you. Wiracocha, sort of surrounding your cocoon of love, comes all around you there. So you're opening separate space around you. And the more you practice this, the more you feel it. And we'll bring our hands together again. On the next in-breath, bring it up into this eighth chakra, and then bring it over the class, bring it over everyone here today, and others watching the future as well, and all around. So just amplify our sacred space, a peaceful space. That's good. Now, if you'd like to pick up your, what we call the fire stick, your death arrow, any of those negative thoughts or feelings or emotions that you have, just want you to blow into the stick. So have a clear thought of what it is in your head, and then blow it in. I'd like to turn the stick a little bit between each one. Watching this, if you have a toothpick, you can use that, or a rolled up bit of paper, or you can do it later. And then when you're ready, just put it to the fire. Just be careful. If you want to use the safety tray underneath, you can. Just allowing and releasing all of those negative thoughts, feelings, energies. Every time the flame is different. Sometimes two, sometimes three, sometimes spitting, sometimes not. Before it gets too close to your fingers so you don't singe yourself, you can turn it up so it back burns onto itself. the end, that last releasement, the last puff of smoke. In the own time, there's no rush. Something you can do at home. I do it mornings and evenings. I do it when I'm taking my online classes as well. So just to let go of the thoughts or negative feelings and emotions. As the others are doing it, you can sit either with your hands on your lap. You can sit with your touching any of your fingers, because they're all different energy parts of the body, energy systems. Or you can have your hand on the palm, just introducing the energy from Pachamama, from Mother Earth, into the body. So whatever you feel comfortable. Good, and then if you have your crystals, place them in your hands. Left hand arrow pointing in, right hand arrow pointing out. And just the thumb around the fingers. Just closing your eyes. Know that any inside or outside noises or sounds that you hear, allowing you to go into deeper levels of relaxation, deeper levels of meditation. Anytime you feel uncomfortable, please just change position. Be careful of the fires around you. The breathing. Always the breathing. I can be aware of your breath moving in and out of your body. That sensation, that feeling as it comes in, out of your nose or your mouth. When you breathe in, be mindful and aware of how your abdomen expands, your tummy expands as you breathe in. How you breathe, as you breathe out, how it contracts and it comes back. Be mindful and aware of all the feelings and sensations through your body. Relaxing there, I'd like you to picture, visualize, imagine the relaxation coming down from the top of your head, from the top of your head and your forehead, your eyes, nose, cheeks, around your mouth and chin, relaxing, muscles around your jaw, relaxing. We're going to allow that relaxation down the back of your head. Some see it feel like a scan, others like a tingling sensation. Now bring that relaxation down to your neck, down out of your shoulders. Just feeling your shoulders relaxing. Bring and allow that relaxation down your arms, your shoulders down to your elbows, biceps and triceps relaxing. Elbows into your wrists, muscles of your forearms relaxing. Wrists into your hands, top of your hands, palms, at the ends of your fingers. Allow the relaxation to come down the front of your body and your your chest down into your abdomen, down your back, upper back, middle back, lower back, down to your waist. Relax. Bring now that relaxation down your thighs to your knees, front of your thighs. Knees down into your ankles, your calves. Ankles into your feet, tops of your feet, heels, arches, balls of your feet, out the ends of your toes. This relaxation now you have in the top of your head, all the way down to the tips of your toes. Crystals in your hands, the energy coming in through your left hand, working up through the arm, around your body, your head, legs, making its way out and around, down through your right hand. Visualizing, imagining that, feeling that, sensing that, being aware of different sensations that that brings, allowing you to go to these deeper levels of meditation as you're now abandoning time, enjoying these deep levels of relaxation. Breathe in just a little bit deeper than before. And I can breathe out just a little bit further than before, but both without being forced. Breathing in. Breathing out through your nose or your mouth, whatever's comfortable for you. The breast at the count of two. We'll breathe in for two, hold for two, breathe out for two, hold for two. We'll do that three or four times and then we'll go on to counts of four. So when you're ready now, breathing in, one, two, hold, one, two, out. One, two, hold, one, two, and again, one, two, hold, out, hold, and again, hold. More time, in, out, now for the count of four, breathing in, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, out, two, three, four, hold. Again, in, hold, out, hold, in, Keep going. Introduce the drum. Just carry on with your breathing cycle. Back to your normal breathing rhythm. Listen to the drum. Allow the vibration of the drum to work in and through your body as you're allowing this to help heal yourself. Change position. Any itches, sets them, any thoughts coming in, be aware of them but pay no attention to them. Breathing normally there now and join this peaceful state of relaxation. More. And more. And more. Relax to know that you're relaxed inside this work has a special bubble that you had around you. More and more. It's like a crystal dome. We're sitting inside it, within it. We protect ourselves from the static of the world. Within this luminous sphere, you can sense and feel the quietness. The stillness that pervades the space. When we amplify it around us, it is amplified many times. This radiant ball all around us, this eighth chakra. Luxury of abandoning time. You know that sleeping is healing, you know that meditation is healing, and allowing this self-healing to take place. Today's meditation, we're practicing the beginner's mind. This beginner's mind requires us to let go of our preconceived notions. our lives become much simpler when we aren't weighed down by the baggage of our stories and expectations. When we open ourselves up to the opportunities presented to us. Innocence and spontaneity infuse our lives again. We lose the attitude of being there, done that. Not that we forget our years of experience, we simply don't confuse what we learned yesterday with what we're discovering today. We develop a hypothetical relationship with life instead of a fixed one. Then if we encounter a situation we've been before, we don't assume the outcome, because when we do, it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. We notice an opportunity to offer our support and find a way to reconnect in a loving way, further cementing relationships. Practicing beginner's mind requires us to give up our dogma, whatever it is. Of course, this is easier said than done when that dogma seems to have served us well. And while we think of religion as being rigid, science can become rigidly ideological as well, as if it were a body of knowledge instead of a way of acquiring knowledge. We can return to a more creative, open, childlike way of being by making simple changes in our routines and habits, such as eating with the opposite hand, taking a different way to go home, smiling instead of getting angry or when you're upset. We can shatter our complicity with the mediocrity around us and open ourselves up to a much wider range of possibilities. The following exercise will help you open yourself up to the new by getting rid of what is not working for you. Have an exercise to clear the junk out of your life. To practice beginner's mind, you must blur and clear the debris of your life. This means emptying your closets of all the junk and collectibles you know you don't need and you're being reluctant to get rid of. The clutter that keeps you tied to the past, that stuffed animal, collared sweatshirt you've outgrown, and so on. You'll still remember the pleasures of these experiences, but without the tangible symbols that are stuffing your closets. Allow yourself to release the expectations you had of yourself and accept that you've made different choices. Clear out your attic, your basement, your overloaded shelves. Let go of the belief that you have to continue to possess any object that might be worth something. Give it to the less fortunate rather than clinging to the illusion that the more objects you possess, the more security and prosperity you have. Make your home, desk, car, closet, and mind minimalist spaces. We practice beginner's mind by getting rid of limiting beliefs about scarcity, abundance, intimacy, and self-worth. Ultimately, we release that feelings and emotions of hold us in back. And we realize that every belief is limiting. And we toss them all into the recycling bin. We then develop a hypothetical relationship with the world, testing every notion we have for its usefulness. We understand that believing is seeing, and that the universe will validate every belief we hold about the nature of reality. When we stop identifying with our thoughts, the ego dissolves because it stems from the belief that I think, therefore I am. We need to take every single belief we have about the nature of our reality and fling it into the fire. After thou have been incinerated, we're free to reinvent ourselves and our world. And then the amateur within us finds the true beloved. Sit in silence for a moment and contemplate where you are weighed down by old stories, expectations, and closets full of all the junk and collectibles you know you don't need to have, and been reluctant to get rid of. Take a moment and think about those now. Yourself back to the breathing. Always the breathing. This peacefulness, this solitude. Relaxed and letting go. Practice of the beginner's mind, taking ourselves back on a regular basis to clear out the closets. By home and our mind. How refreshing. Being aware of the breath coming in and out of your body. Any discomforts, change position to make yourself comfortable. And if any of those inside or outside noises or sounds that you hear, allow you to go deeper levels of relaxation. Energies and crystals working its way in and through your body, cleaning, cleansing, healing. back to Mother Earth, to Pachamama, to Gaia. All the way back to ourselves, starting with ourselves and working out. I'd like you to picture, visualize, imagine coming out the top of your head, a color, any color of the rainbow that you choose. Coming up from the top of your head and going all the way around you, encompassing you like a cocoon. This color is full of peace, love, light, healing and protection. Peace, love, light, healing and protection. Imagine, feel, picture is coming up on top of you here, all the way around you now. Now take this light and expand to take it out, encompassing the room that you're in, like sound waves moving out from your body. This peace, love, light, healing and protection. Now from this room around the buildings, and now around the neighborhood, spreading out this peace, love, light, healing and protection. From the neighborhood now, take it out and around the village, or your town or city that you're in. Coming up from you, from the top of your head, sharing this out, sharing this peace, love, light, healing and protection. Now, around the nation or the country, and neighboring countries, peace, love, light, healing. Further around, all the way around Mother Earth, around Gaia, around Pachamama. Like a spend, if you're comfortable, to send some extras around the Ukraine. These times of challenges here, it's peace, love, light, healing and protection. And now, let's come from the top of the head, all the way around the world, all around Mother Earth, out into the universe, from your head, giving back, sharing peace, sharing love, sharing light, sharing healing, sharing protection. Yourself back to your breathing. Aware of your breathing. Mindful of any sensations or feelings you have around your body. Allow the vibrations of the drum to work in with your relaxation. This healing vibration going in through your body.
back to your breathing, back to your mind, to your body. Any thoughts that come in, be aware of them, but pay no attention to them. Any of these sounds allow you to go to deeper levels of relaxation. Take a moment now, think of all the things that you're grateful for in your life, a moment of gratitude. Allowing it now. You to take some time and think of your intentions for practicing meditation. Your intentions for this evening, intentions for the weekend and days ahead. For the weeks and months ahead, believing who and what you really are. Relaxed. Mindful of your breath again. Mindful of the body as it's in contact with the floor, the mat, or where you are. Mindful of the beautiful being that you are. Crystals in your hands, you still hold them. The energy flowing in through your body, cleaning, cleansing, rejuvenating, energizing. And then out through your right hand. Be mindful of your giving back to Mother Earth. Everything back to you, this peace, love, light, healing and protection. Be mindful of your beginner's mind, clearing out our clutter. Place we're in right now. one to five. On the count of number five, I'll say the word up. And on your own time, you become fully aware, fully calm, rested, refreshed, relaxed, you're feeling wonderful. One, slowly, calmly, easily and gently return to your full awareness once again. Two, every muscle, nerve, fibre in your body, loose, limp and relaxed, feeling wonderful. Three, from head to toe, you're feeling perfect in every way. Physically perfect, mentally perfect, emotionally calm and serene. Number four, your eyes will feel sparkling clear as a bathe in a cool spring mountain stream. In your own time, on the next number now, you'll be fully aware, feeling calm, rested, refreshed, relaxed, feeling wonderful. Number five, up. In your own time, open your eyes. Take a deep breath. Fill up your lungs. Stretch and smile. Welcome back. Well done. So we're just going to close our world culture, our sacred space. And we do that by imagining them like folds of a blanket. We're going to fold, scoop them up from around us and around the class. And bring it back up into this eighth chakra, this eighth energy field. Then we're going to bring down the universe for our highest good, down into our body. Energy down and through, and then we're going to give a little bit extra for Pachamama from Mother Earth for her much needed healing at this time. And then we're going to gather up the folds of your own world culture, bringing them up and around and bringing you back up this golden orb of light, this energy field. Again, only for our highest good, it was for our highest good down to our energy centers, so our seven chakras. Bringing it down through the body. And then a little extra for Pachamama. Hi, well done. Namaste. Aho.